we don't ever study is that 10-year period when they were alive longer, and yeah, they consume more healthcare, but maybe their quality of life and the value to society that was there was significantly better. But in studies, you never measure that, right? We're measuring total costs over a given period, and we measure mortality. And it's really tough in primary care, for example, like what I do. I've always argued that what we do with patients with chronic illness, like if you guys ever work with me, like poor Chris yesterday, we see 20 people in an afternoon who have 8 or 10 things wrong with them, and we're just trying to cajole it into managing it as best we can, and hopefully we're like slowing, instead of them declining in 5 years and getting both their legs cut off, and then getting on renal dialysis and living 2 more years and then dying. We're trying to stretch it out to 8 or 10 with nobody measuring the quality of life under that curve, because nobody wants to measure that stuff. But that's what my hope is, that this good disease management, quality primary care can do, but it would have to be prioritized, right? And maybe you have to pay people incentives for that quality of life under the curve instead of for, reduced expenditures over a period or for, mortality outcomes or something else. It's complicated, but I think it is a collective area.
There's a good example of this, in something that's just a trend that's happened in medicine, and that is the role of the hospital. The hospital is as a physician who usually has been trained in more acute care, ICU kind of care, and he basically spends all the time in the hospital, is paid by the hospital. A hospital 6 years ago, if you got paid 100